The recent Channel 4 incident and the United Nations' general attitude towards Sri Lanka has become a talking point viewed with much concern by Sri Lankans in the country and overseas. Today, we meet someone who's taken that concern a little further, reflecting his thoughts in a song which has proved to be immensely popular. Here's musician, songwriter and singer Rukshan Perera. Hello, Rukshan. Welcome to News Now. Actually, your song, Shame on You, could very well be a rallying cry for Sri Lankans protesting against what is generally considered as biased conduct by the United Nations and much of the Western world.
Yes, Navelin, first of all, thank you very much for inviting me here. Yes, absolutely right. I think Sri Lanka being an underdeveloped country, a small country, we get bullied by the big ones all the time. But United Nations in general, they are supposed to be treating all countries equally, but we clearly see that's not happening. We can see how US and all the allies went into Iraq, just claiming there was WMDs, weapons of mass destruction, and just went about and bombed the country and took out Saddam. And today, what's the situation? More than a million deaths, all civilians. Where is the human rights violation? There's no such thing. But Sri Lanka,
they've got double standards.
Absolutely. But Sri Lanka, on the other hand, finished a terrorist war, and we are being penalized for finishing a terrorist war. So obviously there is double standards. And as a musician, I feel that I need to write a song about this and show what I had to say.
Now, besides, of course, the appeal of the music itself in the song, what do you think made this immensely popular with the Sri Lankan audiences?
Yeah, I'm also completely surprised. I have put it on YouTube just 4 days ago. And in fact, yesterday I went to sleep and I saw the hit count was 5,000. Today I wake up in the morning, it was 7,000. I was like, whoa. I didn't expect all that. But I think all Sri Lankans in all races, I'm talking for all races, they all feel what I have just said in the song, that we don't have a voice, unfortunately, because we are a small country and the other countries are bullying us, and the UN is just playing, with all the double standards, unfortunately, we are getting trampled. So I think that's the reason everybody is rallying around this song and supporting, and I'm getting a lot of emails and a lot of calls for this song.
Right. Do you believe that music is an effective platform to air your views, to get your message to the world?
Yeah, music is, in general, it's a universal language. Everybody understands music. And you put the same message in a tune and with a melody and with some backing tracks, and I think it definitely is something that's what you see, what we are seeing today after putting this song on YouTube and getting so popular so quickly. It actually shows that everybody is behind this message.
Right, in case you haven't seen the song before or heard it, here's Rukshan together with Sohan and Rajita. Shame on you.
When the West claimed there were WMD and bombed in the name of democracy, where were you? UN, where were you? When they openly tortured prisoners of war, violated all human rights law, where were you? UN, where were you?
Their death toll is in millions, and they all innocent civilians. But only now you are talking of human rights.
Banky, you must be kidding, right?
For 30 long years when we lived in fear and suicide bombs danced in the air, where were you? UN, where were you?
When our children were forcefully dragged into war, who didn't know what they were fighting for? Where were you? UN, where were you?
We finally ended a brutal war. Now working on peace we've been waiting for.
But now you are talking of human rights.
Banky, you must be kidding, right?
Shame, shame on writing unfair reports to divide us. Shame on you. You and shame on you.
Do 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 da do da da do da da.
Yes, we have learned lessons from the past. We have gone beyond the race and caste. Don't you see? We want lasting peace.
We're resettling families in North and East, embracing our brothers for lasting peace.
Don't you see? We want lasting peace.
Yes, we need support from the world at large, to soothe our souls and forgive our past,
to mend our minds and the wounded hearts,
uplift our nation, don't break us apart.
Shame on you.
Playing double standards and bullying us, writing unfair reports to divide us.
Shame on you.
You and shame on you.
Shame on you.
Shame on you.
You and shame on you.
Shame on you.
Shame on you.
You and shame on
you. Do 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 da 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 da
on you.
You recently got much attention on social networks with your very creative compilation of nursery rhymes, with, of course, a very special take on Bohemian Rhapsody by Queen. How did that come about?
Well, Bohemian Rhapsody, from the first day I heard it, I enjoyed that very much. I thought that was a fabulous piece of work. And back in the 70s, I was with the Super Golden Chimes at the time. I did that song with the Super Golden Chimes, and then when I joined Esquire Set and went abroad, I did the song again with Esquire Set.
With a lot of harmony, of course. You it need has lots a lot of voices.
Yes, absolutely. And it's not easy harmonies either. It's mm-hmm. a sort of complicated harmonies. So Bohemian Rhapsody has always been in my head, running. Mm-hmm. On and off, I hear these things. And all of a sudden, I heard, instead of, "Is this the real life?" I heard, "Mega Seboho." I would just hear these things. Naturally, and then all of a sudden this blah, 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 aturu mituru damadi.
I particularly like that part. You paralleled the Queen's version of that, the original,
yeah.
And use aturu mituru damati vaturu. That's excellent.
Yeah, so those are things just come to my mind, and then I just put it. So once, when a few clips came to my mind, I thought, you know what, I need to write a song. Mm-hmm. Similar to Bohemian Rhapsody, but not in that tune or anything, but just that format. So people will just enjoy.
Mega Seboho, Perido Dantide, Peila Idila Pimatana Vila,
samanalaya malvara pani bonta malvara pani bonta samanalayo numa ave mokada mage malvat. Obedi lisena
Aturu mituru tamadi vaturu raj kapuru settiya Aruta geta mandamalita haal pata karala Ihela geta bedala pahala geta bedala
Kukula kapa vata mulle Kikili kapa dora mulle Atakkani settiya
Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall sat on the wall Humpty Dumpty had a great fall
Ambala me pina Malankandak gena Eka binda bigona Pinata harihina
Ambala me pina Malankandak gena Eka binda bigona Pinata harihina
Tikiri 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 liya Kale taran litata liya
Lita vata kara kabara goya Akula ka piniya bariya
So how long did you take to complete the song?
Normally to write a song, it takes about a day for me to write a song with melody and lyrics. But this one took me probably maybe 2 or 3 days to put everything together. And then the recording, of course, took a little longer.
Rukshan, more of your amazing talents in making the rounds in the form of whistling in harmony. How do you do that?
Well, everybody asks me how I whistle in two parts, a melody and a harmony together. I find it very difficult to explain to anybody how I do it. It's as difficult as you try to explain to a person who cannot whistle. I mean, what do you say? You say that you keep your mouth like this and blow. That's all you can say, right?
Some can hardly whistle a note.
That's true. That's true. So all I do is I sort of split the whistle into two sections. And one comes from this side, one comes from the other, but I have total control over both. So that's why I can do the one in harmony and one on the melody, and I can go parallel, I can go whatever the way I want with the two whistles.
Right. It's amazing. I mean, harmony alone is difficult enough, but then to remember the melody line and the harmony and whistle it,
true,
amazing.
True. It has gone a long way.
Do you think your whistling apparatus is in good fettle to actually give us a demo of that now?
Sure. Okay, so, okay, here is just a melody line.
Mm-hmm.
And now the melody and a harmony line together.
Wow. Do you think you can do a little bit of a song at least?
Sure.
Rukshan, that's absolutely amazing. I can't imagine how you could do that. I think some of the songs that we spoke about today are on your CD, the recent CD that you have released.
Correct.
Can we expect something else very soon?
I actually started first doing a jazz album when I was in the States. I started recording that. I didn't finish it. So when I came back to Sri Lanka to settle down, I thought, you know what? First CD should not be a jazz one because that's a very limited audience anyway.
Yeah.
So I wanted to do a pop CD. That's what I did as the first one. So next I would like to do a jazz CD. As well, a lot of people have asked me why I'm not doing a Sinhalese CD because I do sing Sinhalese
yes.
songs as well. So that's also in the pipeline. So I'll be probably, if not end of this year, next year definitely I will be finishing the jazz and a Sinhalese album.
Are there any unusual songs that we can look forward to in that?
There will be. That'll be a surprise.
Right, we're waiting for the surprise and looking forward to it, Rukshan. Well, we'll be keeping track of your new ventures and we're looking forward to all of that.
Noeline, thank you so much for inviting me, and I would like to thank News Now as well for inviting me for this session, and I really enjoyed this morning. Thank you.
Thank you. Musician, singer and songwriter Rukshan Perera joining me on News Now to talk about his unusual new compositions and his very popular protest song, Shame on You. I'm Noeline Hunter. Thank you for being with us on News Now.